Hey guys, this video is sponsored by G2A.com. G2A.com is a website where you can find thousands of games for extremely cheap prices. Make sure to check out the link in the description for more. Hey guys, Paul with Weapons of the World here, and today we're going to be taking a look at the strange looking, kind of odd, really not super well known Calico M100. Some basic information about the M100. Its country of origin is the United States. It was manufactured by the Calico Light Weapon Systems Manufacturing. Total weight is about 4 pounds loaded. Barrel length is 16 inches. Caliber is 22 LR, so long rifle. It's just a very simple blowback operated carbine, I guess you could say. It only fires in semi-automatic. Has an effective range of only about 100 yards, maybe 150 if you kind of pushed it out. And the real probably the weirdest thing about this is actually the magazine. It uses a 100 round helical or a 50 round helical magazine. With the 100 round, I believe that makes it the largest single capacity magazine for a I guess a carbine or a rifle. I can't really think of any magazine standard that has over 100 rounds in it. Especially for this caliber, for 22, I can think of maybe the 100 round Beta C drum mag for the AR-15, and there's probably a couple others, but it's a very high capacity magazine, especially for this time. It came out in, I believe, the 70s or 80s. I'm sorry, it was released in 1980. So let's talk about some features of this gun. It has a under folding stock. It kind of just slides into the receiver. It's very hard to describe exactly. It reminds me a lot like a Spaz 12 shotgun's stock. However, instead of folding up top, it folds underneath the gun like that. It also has this weird looking handguard. Kind of reminds me of like the M16A2. However, not nearly as really effective or cool looking. It's a very weird looking gun, which kind of aided in its in the fact that it wasn't very popular. It didn't sell well on the civilian or military market. Really, no one wanted this thing. So let's actually take a look on the inside of the gun. So here you can see this helical magazine and kind of how it works. Everything's in a spiral, like a really long spiral slide is basically the closest thing I can think of. It's just a very simple blowback operated gun. Let me show you what the magazine looks like fully loaded. So you can see how all the rounds just wrap around the entire magazine, which is probably why they used the 22 LR caliber in the first place, just because of how small it is. You can really fit a bunch of bullets into the helical magazine. So like I said, it's very straightforward, very simple operation, just a straight blowback operation. The recoil of the round firing pushes the bolt back, cocks the hammer, and ejects the next round. You really can't, there's nothing really special when it comes to the actual operation of the gun, other than the helical magazine, how it feeds from the top. It's just kind of strange. That's just about it. There's nothing particularly exciting about this gun. It looks weird, it kind of acts weird. It's not the most reliable thing in the world. Granted, it has its hiccups every now and then, but all in all, it's just a sound design. The weirdest thing about it is just how it looks. With this weird, it's not really a muzzle brake, but it's not a muzzle device of really any kind. I guess it could be a flash suppressor in a way. The iron sights are really not that great. In fact, each magazine had its own set of iron sights. So it's just a weird gun. There's really nothing too exciting about this gun other than the fact that it has this weird magazine. It's just, I don't know how to explain it in any other way. Again, it didn't sell well in the civilian market, and in fact, during the Clinton administration, when it came to the federal assault weapons ban in the 80s, it actually was made illegal to even manufacture this gun for civilian sale. So for a while, this gun did not appear on the market at all in the form of anything new. However, once the assault weapons ban was lifted, they were allowed to produce these, and in fact, I believe they still produce these today in different models. They have a pistol variant with no stock and I think a shorter barrel. They even made a walnut variant where the stock and the handguard is made out of walnut wood. And that looks kind of cool if you want to pull up a picture of that, but the same design is used, so there's, again, it's just nothing special. So I think that wraps it up on this weird looking gun. Again, there's just nothing special about this gun. The operation is straightforward, just blow back. The only thing weird is this helical magazine that holds 100 rounds or 50 rounds. You couldn't really mount any optics of any kind. And it's just a weird gun. You know, I'm sorry this is not a very informative video, but there's really nothing to talk about on this gun other than what I've already said. So, sorry to disappoint you guys, I guess. But thanks for watching anyways, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to like and subscribe for more. Bye.